First of all, can you guys tell us a little bit about the movie and why you chose to work on the project?
For me, it was a completely new genre, and when I got a phone call asking if I was interested in it, I think I got a bit terrified of the idea of doing a space film. And then I talked to Danielle and I heard his insight and his way of wanting to make a realistic reality sci-fi film, and I thought, I'm on board, I want to try this one out.
I was the very last person involved, so there were a lot of elements to me that were interesting. I mean, I think the quality of filmmaking, in particular with Daniel and all the department heads we have on the movie, it's sort of the highest level. A movie that is fun to watch but also has real artistic intent was really alluring to me. And then just the psychology of a character, I think, that didn't respond the way I would have expected him to respond. And then I think also on top of that, there were two women at the center of the movie that were very strong characters, and it is very much a sort of ensemble piece in that way, but at the same time I really loved the fact that you had an equality, and even more so on the female side, much weightier women's roles, women who are doing really strong, fascinating work. So,
yeah. And both of your characters have, like, they have a background, they have a story, and the whole thing is very profound, and we get attached to them. You guys all, well, most of the movie they spend in zero gravity, which is very interesting for us to see. I think it's the first time that we get to see something during the whole film. Mm-hmm. How did you guys work on that? Did you get, like, a special training from NASA to become, like, astronauts, or...?
I did research. I looked at a lot of videos of movement, but then we had Alex Reynolds, who was the movement coach and stunt coordinators. So we had an incredible team around us who worked with us, and to individually find our characters' sort of individual moves and how we take corners, or if you curve around a corner, or just it was incredible. Hard work, a lot of harness hanging and bumping into each other.
Yeah, I mean, we had a number of advisors on the film, and really, I think, you know, an incredible stunt team, and just incredible acrobats as well, that we worked with all the time in tandem with, sometimes for us. But yeah, like Rebecca said, there was an intent that Daniel Espinosa's intent throughout this movie was to try and make each one of these people very specific, each one of the characters you meet, so that eventually when, you know, their lives are tried or they're in a situation where things are being pushed, that it becomes more and more complicated. And one of those things was the way in which we moved in zero gravity, you know, that, like Rebecca said, some people were much more assured and would be able to move quicker in certain situations. Some people were more physical, just generally some people weren't. And so we all moved differently.
Well, like your character had been in space the longest.
Yeah.
There was a certainty, there was an absoluteness over your movement. I was a new recruit, which is fun to play with and capture. It came automatically to Jake's character, not for mine.
Yeah, it felt easier for his character, actually. I have a tricky question now. If you guys could choose three words to describe the whole experience of this movie.
Three words.
Exhausting. Exhilarating. Let's do it again.
Chafing.
It's going to become a competition of good words.
Of harness. you know, it was fun. You know, essentially, it was fun. I've spent a good amount of time over the past number of years, pushing myself in different ways, and it's always fun, you know. But this was real fun. In the same way, I think it will be for the audience, you know.
Yeah. It was my last question. Those performances were great. I think it's one of the best sci-fi movies I've seen in a couple of years. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.